to Coral Gables Congregational Church. We are part of the United Church of Christ, and we welcome you, no matter who you are or where you are on your life journey. A very special welcome to our visitors and guests who are with us for the very first time today. We are most honored by your presence, and we hope that following our service, all of you, family, friends, visitors alike, will join us in the fellowship hall for a time of some informal conversation and some refreshments. We also want to say a warm welcome to those who are worshiping with us online today from around the world. We are so delighted to have you as well. And I'm going to ask all of you who are at home or wherever you are online with us, as well as all of you who are here in our beautiful sanctuary, to please sign in. Let us know of your presence today. There is a red pad on the inside of the pews. Just pick that up. The first person on the inside, sign in, send it down the pew, send it back. We really appreciate you allowing us to know that you are here with us today. We have a couple of very special guests that I would like to introduce, but first I want to say welcome home to Jesus Silva. Is Jesus here? Where is Jesus? There he is. Some of you will remember Jesus. He was a member of our choir for many years. He was the chair of our board for congregational life, and he has come all the way from California to be here for our Music Appreciation Sunday. I'm sure that's why you're here. So please stand so we can say a warm welcome home to you. I'm also so pleased to say welcome to Reverend Joffrey Black and his wife, Pat. Joffrey and Pat, are you here? Wonderful. Please stand. And I will tell you that we are honored by their presence. Joffrey is the former general minister and president of the United Church of Christ. He served us well for many years, and he is here with us over the month of June. He is teaching our 945 adult education program on the journey of jazz. And next Sunday, he will be preaching, and joining him will be a jazz ensemble called Trad 305. So it's going to be a great Sunday, and for those of you who love jazz and great music, it will be a very special Sunday. So I hope to see you all next week as well. And he's here, Pastor Aaron Lauer, our new associate. I think so far, so good. Now, you realize he's come in from Minnesota, so there's a little change in temperature and a little change in geography and so forth, but he looks like he's doing okay. So we are delighted to have you with us, Aaron. One of the great clues that summer is here is always our community arts program summer concert series. And it begins this Thursday evening right here in our sanctuary. If you have not gotten your tickets yet, please do. The opening act, the opening performance this Thursday night is Doc Severinsen. How many of you remember Doc Severinsen? How many of you are really old? Okay, we're anyway, he is still going, but has a great band with him. It's going to be just a wonderful evening. And as I always say, there's no place better to be on a warm summer South Florida night than listening to some very cool music right here in this space. Well, as you have probably figured out or know, today is Music Sunday. And I think the great irony is that on Music Appreciation Sunday, Choir Appreciation Sunday, we make them work hard. So we are so grateful. I think every Sunday here is actually Music Sunday because we are so blessed with such great singers, ringers, musicians, directors, and so forth. And so I would just like to do a brief introduction. First, we are so pleased to have Seth Woods on the drums today and Tim Smith on the bass guitar. They are over here. And then we also have our handbell choir. Those of you who are in the handbell choir, will you stand so we can say thank you for your work? And every week, we are so happy to have our vocal ensemble, those special people who bring some grounding to our choir and special performances. And I know some of you are back there, some of you are here, but will our vocal ensemble stand or raise your hand so we can say thank you to all of you. And then, of course, our chancel choir, all of you back there and around here, thank you so much for your music week after week. Dr. Greg Taylor, who is our parish musician, we are so grateful for his beautiful music. Ron, come here for just for a second. And I finally want to say a special thanks. Dr. Ron Morgan is our director of music ministry. He and I have worked together for 25 years doing this together. We've been friends a lot longer, but I can't imagine doing this with anyone else or anyone else that I know who loves church music more and strives to provide just the highest quality and the most meaning to music. So thank you, Ron. So, my friends, indeed, we gather on this joyous Sunday, on this day filled with beautiful music and song. We gather as the people of God in this place, celebrating, rejoicing, and singing our praises. Let us be together in a time of worship. for our call to worship. In the presence of God, tears emerge from a hidden ache. Joy ascends like a rocket in the sky.
God is here.
Trusting that the fullness of the divine will hear our plea and and grant us mercy that makes us whole again. With that trust, let us pray together.
You are a God who finds us even when we withdraw. We cannot hide from you. You know our fears, our hesitations, our failures, and our doubts. Yet you see us in mercy and appear to us in grace. Make us into new people who may live toward the future instead of being confined by the past. Lord,
shot. You are more beloved than you can ever know, and God is working in you and in the world beyond our wildest imagining. The beginning of all of that is forgiveness. So know that you are indeed forgiven, and be at peace. Amen. God's grace through Jesus Christ, we therefore know God's peace. As a sign of that peace, let us share it with one another. The peace of Christ be with you.
Praise God in this house of prayer. Praise God for the loving example of Christ. Praise God with the blast of trumpets. Praise God with timbrel and dance. Praise God with drums and cymbals.
Give praise with thundering
voice. Let everything that draws breath praise God.
Praise, yes, praise our wonderful God.
conceived by the Holy
Every morning, I want to kneel down on the golden cloth of the sand and say some kind of musical thanks for the world that is happening again. Another day. From the shawl of the wind coming out of the west to the firm green flesh of the melon lately sliced open and eaten. Its chill and ample body flavored with mercy. I want to be worthy. of what? Glory? Yes. Unimaginable glory. O Lord of melons, of mercy, though I am not ready nor worthy, I am climbing toward you.
For all of this beautiful music, for this lovely sanctuary where we come to worship each week, for this community of believers, for the bold witness of this faith community in our community and beyond. For all of these things, we are so very grateful. And now we have the opportunity to share a portion of our gratitude so that the ministry and mission of this church might continue. Will the ushers please come forward as we gather up our morning offerings, pledges, and tithes.
Thank you. the living God. We give thanks for the opportunity to express our love for you and for one another through the powerful mystery of rhythm, the joy of song, and in these offerings we present to you. May our expressions of word, melody, and treasure honor you now and always. Amen.
Thank you. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
Lord.
It is right. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
We gather here, gracious God, with hearts of thanksgiving and praise. We give thanks for all the gifts with which you have blessed us, for the created world in which we live, for family and friends with whom we share our lives, for food on our plates and roofs over our heads, for all those things that make life abundant. We offer our thanks and praise.
I'm blind and who could not see?
betrayed, Jesus ate a very special meal with his friends. As part of that gathering, he took some bread, he blessed it, he broke it, and he gave it to them, saying, "This is my body broken for you. This do in remembrance of me." And likewise, after supper, he took the cup. He gave thanks, blessed it, and he gave it to them, saying, "This is the cup of the new covenant poured out for each of you. This do in remembrance of me. Take and drink." So now, gracious God, we ask that you pour out your spirit upon this gathering, this table, this meal. As we eat and drink in fellowship with each other, may we be filled with hope for the future. Lord, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us and grant us your peace. Amen.
Thank you.
And together we pray the prayer our Lord taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. These are the gifts of God for the people of God. Come, all things are ready.
Please stand for our prayer.
Please stand for our prayer of thanksgiving. The bread has been broken, the cup has been poured, the meal has been shared. Gracious God, we give thanks for bread for the journey, for your wisdom guiding us along the way. May they be friends to share the road as we dare to dream of creation renewed and hope in the promise for justice for all. Amen.
Listen to the blessing of music. May we know this ending is more than a time of goodbye. May the warmth of this community, the love of God, and the memory of our time together this day sustain our hearts and encourage our minds as we engage the blessings of life's challenges and joys. The service has ended. Your service has begun. Go in peace. Go in joy, go in love. Amen. You may be seated.